Time now to go bush with news that might ruffle some feathers. Aotearoa's Bird of the Century has been crowned. This year's competition extra special, celebrating Forest and Bird's 100th birthday. And the winner by a landslide, the Pūteketeke. And we can thank this guy for that, US talk show host John Oliver. He got many in a flap when he made himself the global campaign manager for the Australasian crested grebe. The native bird with its distinctive orange mullet is classed as nationally vulnerable, with fewer than 1,000 here in New Zealand. And because of the worldwide campaign, there were unprecedented voting numbers. More than 350,000 verified votes were cast from 195 countries, the biggest ever for the competition. The previous record, just under 57,000. Some honourable mentions, the brown kiwi coming in second, and these little guys, the fantail and the black robin, making the top 10. As well as the kakapo, scored fourth place. Kate Nicol-Williams has more details and reaction.
Like many of our birds, this species is classed as threatened. But now it's in a category of its own, Bird of the Century.
I like his little orange mullet.
I think it's a wonderful bird. I have no grudge against the Pūteketeke.
My friend got a little bit passionate about the fact that some of the votes are quite biased. But I don't care. I think it's cute.
The Pūteketeke received nearly 300,000 votes. That's 22 times as many as the runner-up. In a competition known for controversy, this year's foreign interference will be hard to top.
Anyone can campaign for a bird. That seemed like a vulnerability in their system that somebody could exploit.
John Oliver's publicity blitz saw billboards put up around the world. The wacky Pūteketeke shot to stardom, while the campaign manager badmouthed his rivals.
No, that's a hipster penguin! What are you?
Others raised concerns about the Australasian crested grebe's dual citizenship. But the man that's dedicated the last decade to helping it is overjoyed.
And suddenly this happens, and it's just almost unbelievable.
The bird's known for its courtship act and protecting their young.
Within an hour or so of the chicks hatching, they crawl onto the back of the adult. And they're nurtured on the backs of the adults. They never go back underneath the birds.
Conservationists are celebrating the international eyes on our vulnerable species.
It can only be a positive thing that 200 countries around the world decided to participate in voting for New Zealand's most special birds.
With many of those voters donating, it's also boosted Forest and Birds' annual fundraising. Tourism New Zealand riding the publicity wave too, inviting the talk show host to visit.
Now, getting awareness of New Zealand and getting awareness of the fantastic bird life in New Zealand is a great win, I think.
There's been no post-victory peep from Oliver.
Together, let's make bird history!
An historic win for an international TV star and his feathered friend. Kate Nicol-Williams, One News.